My dear respected brothers and sisters, today inshallah ta'ala, the topic of discussion will be, no doubt, something that we always need to remind ourselves of. And this is to improve our character and to have good manners. Husnul khuluq. Indeed, in Islam, husnul khuluq, or having good manners, or improving our character, has a high status. And it lifts a Muslim's level of iman, and it brings goodness towards him and the society. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent down the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as a mercy to mankind. وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ, to all of mankind. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala raised his rank, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he described him and said, وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَىٰ خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ, that indeed you, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you are upon a great and noble status in your manners, in your mannerism, in your character. Allah has elevated his status, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he reminded Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in another ayah, وَلَوْ كُنْتَ فَضًّا غَلِيظَ الْقَلْبِ لَمْ فَضُّوا مِنْ حَوْلِكَ, that even the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, with his stature and status, where he received the wahi and the Qur'an, that if he would not have good akhlaq and good manners and good character, then people would have turned away. لَمْ فَضُّوا مِنْ حَوْلِكَ, they would have turned away. So we still find that it is something that we need to remind ourselves all the time with. And this is why today my discussion in this khutbah will be to talk about the importance, first of all, of having akhlaq. Because normally what happens is, to achieve something, if we can see the benefit, or if we can see something that we can achieve from doing this action, then it is more likely that we'll do that. We'll try towards achieving that. And that's why if we understand some blessings, some fada'il, some virtues, today I will bring forth to you some ahadith, Quran ayat, that talks about this blessing, these fada'il, these virtues. So we can try to attain it. One khutbah is not sufficient to discuss all of manners and Islamic character, but we can learn about it inshallah ta'ala. So we can improve ourselves throughout the day and night, and we can improve our families and our communities and our society as a whole. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, when he came to the people of Jahiliyyah, he changed the whole Arabian Peninsula through his actions, through his mu'amalat, through his dealings. And people would call him a Sadiq al-Amin, the most truthful, the most trustworthy. Even the people who hated him still knew that he had a great character, sallallahu alayhi wasallam. So Islam teaches to do good actions, to pray, to fast, and all of these actions have a direct relationship with improving ourselves. For example, salah, every week on Friday you hear inna salata tanha anil fahsha'i wal munkar, but we don't know the meaning, that indeed salah removes and stops us, forbids us from doing any fahsha and munkar, from any evil doings. If somebody is up on salah 5 times a day, what happens? Then inshallah ta'ala, it is very less likely that he will be doing some vice or some evil, or some bad thing, or his character. He can improve himself. He will see a change in himself. And the sawm, fasting, same thing. When we keep our fast, there's no point of keeping fast until and unless we control our tongues. So all of these actions that we do in our lives, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has legislated upon us, must at the same time improve our character, improve ourselves. We need to think about improving ourselves. So let's begin with some of the virtues. And the first virtue or fadl or blessing, we could say, is that whenever Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was asked by the sahaba, the companions, about advice, comprehensive advice, then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wasallam used to advise to improve the character, subhanallah. Hadith of Abi Huraira radiyallahu anhu, anna rajulan qala lin nabiy sallallahu alayhi wasallam, awsini, advise me. Sahabi came and said, advise me. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said two words, simple two words. He said, la taghdab, do not be angry. La taghdab, la taghdab. And he faraddada miraran, and he repeated it so many times. He still said, no, awsini, tell me something more. He said, la taghdab. So it's not just, he didn't tell him to do something in, you know, iman or fiqh or something. He just gave him something simple. Do not be angry. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wasallam was given min jawami' al-kalim. He would say small things and it would mean so much. And this is why we understand that, which we'll come to in the khutbah inshallah, is that anger can bring so many problems and so many other issues. And another hadith, Mu'adh ibn Jabal, he was advised when he would go to Yemen, and at the end, before, yani, he was told by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, اتَّقِ اللَّهَ حَيْثُ مَا كُنْتُ, fear Allah wherever you are, and follow وَأَتْبِعِ السَّيِّئَةَ الْحَسَنَ تَمْحُهَا, that then do a good deed after a bad one, yani follow a bad deed with a good deed and it will remove it. And the final advice was وَخَالِقِ النَّاسَ بِخُلُقٍ حَسَنٍ, that wherever you are, in whatever situation, treat others well. Be good in your akhlaq, be good in your manners. Whatever the situation, be good in your manners. This was advice to Mu'adh ibn Jabal. No one is blessed, my dear brothers and sisters, with a better blessing in this dunya than good manners. All of the wealth, all of the position and rank and blessings that we have in this dunya, you can't buy, and it is not something that we can achieve without Allah's blessing and without trying towards improving ourselves in our character. Because the most beloved in this community, or in wherever you a person would go, would be if he has good character. If he has good character, if he has good akhlaq and manners, doesn't matter, he doesn't have to have all the money or all the position, he will be respected. He will be respected. And that's why Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, when he met Abu Dharr, he said, Ya Abu Dharr, ala adulluka ala khaslatain. Shall I tell you about two attributes or two qualities that you should have, you should aspire to? Qala bala ya Rasulullah. He said, yes, ya Rasulullah. He said, alayka bi husni al-khuluqi wa tuli al-sum. Wa tuli al-sum. Yani, you should try to improve yourself in your character. Have good manners, good akhlaq, and spend a long time quiet. Spend most of the time quiet. Don't speak unnecessarily. To improve your character, to improve your akhlaq. فَوَالَّذِي نَفْسِي بِيَدِهِ فَوَالَّذِي نَفْسِي بِيَدِهِ, that for him who's, for my soul, which is in Allah's hands, مَا تَجَمَّلَ الْخَلَائِقَ بِمِثْلِهِمَا, subhanallah, that nothing beautifies a creation except for having these two qualities. What are those two qualities? To have good manners and spend long time being quiet, not speaking so much. This is beautifies our creation as per the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. So this, my dear brothers, the first quality or the first virtue we said is whenever Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam received good advice, it would be to, when Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam gave advice to the Sahaba, it would be to improve their character. Second advice was that how do we achieve? How do we achieve and how do we improve ourselves as a person? How do we improve ourselves in our qualities? Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned here, عَلَيْكَ بِحُسْنِ الْخُلُقِ وَطُولَ الصَّمْتِ. And also, in another hadith, عن جابر رضي الله عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ألا أخبركم بخياركم؟ قالوا بلى يا رسول الله أحسنكم أخلاقا. That the Sahaba came and said, how can Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that the best of you, shall I tell you who are the best of you? The best of the Muslims. Everybody wants to attain to be the best of the Muslims, to improve ourselves, to attain Jannah. Then he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the best of you are the best of those with the best of akhlaq and manners and good character. So the second point is we need to, my dear brothers and sisters, just to remember the advice that to improve ourselves in our deen and in our quality and to achieve Jannah, Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam advised us to improve our character, to be good, to have good manners. And the third fadl and virtue of blessings of good character is one of encouragement, my dear brothers and sisters. Some of us are not doing enough in terms of our worship to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in fasting and in dhikr. And we should feel guilt. However, there is a way of getting those blessings, right? And the hadith of Aisha radiallahu anhu reminds us that she said she heard Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, إِنَّ الْمُؤْمِنَ لَيُدْرِكْ بِحُسْنِ خُلُقِهِ دَرَجَةَ الصَّائِمِ الْقَائِمِ. That a person with a believer who fears Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and he can reach a level, a status with his good character, the same level as somebody who fasts all day and stays up all night for prayer, for tahajjud, for optional salah. Sometimes we're short of this. Some of us, we can remember some brothers or sisters who are, mashallah, worshipping and close to Allah, and doing so much ibadah and nawafil and doing so many sunan, praying and fasting. But sometimes we're not able to do that. But an easy way and a consolation for us is that we can just do something very simple. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is telling us that you la yablu or la yudrik, in another riwayah, la yablu. And he reaches the level of that same person. That person who is fasting in the day and praying in the night. That if we are good in our character, good in our akhlaq and manner, insha'Allah ta'ala. And this is such a simple and easy way. So it's an encouragement for us. And the fourth point, my dear brothers and sisters, is that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in another hadith of Abi Hurairah radiallahu anhu, and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, قال, أَكْمَلُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ إِيمَانًا أَحْسَنُهُمْ خُلُقًا. Subhanallah. The most perfect of believers with iman. We want to perfect ourselves all the time, right? We always want to improve ourselves. And our iman, actually, the sifa and the attribute of somebody who has good iman and perfect iman, insha'Allah ta'ala, is the one with the best of akhlaq and character. Therefore, having iman and having good character goes hand in hand, the same. This is very important to understand. And there's so many ahadith talking about advising to improve ourselves in our character, our relationship with our family members, how we should be with one another, and how we should improve ourselves. Some of the scholars have summarized this into very simple meaning. Ad-deenu, our religion, is husn al-mu'amala. Is to have good relationship, good character with everyone around us. And that means to have good relations and good character and akhlaq, husn al-khuluq, to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala first. That's the first thing. And then with the creation. And then with the creation. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so many ayat, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَأْمُرُ بِالْعَدْلِ وَالْإِحْسَانِ. Indeed, Allah commands you to be just and fair and be good towards one another. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. So we have to learn to be courteous, tell the truth, and avoid lying and doing all the opposite of any good, all the evil. And that's why the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was said about himself, إِنَّمَا بُعِثْتُ لِأُتَمِّمَ مَكَارِمَ الْأَخْلَاقِ. I was only sent to perfect the manners. Perfect. And the best of those with iman, أَكْمَلُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ إِيمَانًا أَحْسَنُهُمْ خُلُقًا. The best of manners. So your iman is high or improved with good manners. And so the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam describes those people. And he says, يَأْلَفُونَ الَّذِينَ يَأْلَفُونَ وَيُؤْلَفُونَ. Those people, that they're always friendly to other people. And they're friendly to others, and they are friendly towards them. They're always comfortable to talk with. They're not difficult to talk to. Some people very difficult to talk to. We need to improve ourselves, remind ourselves. Not someone off-putting. Should be easy, gentle, layin, hayin. Prophet ﷺ was soft and gentle and polite. This is the description that we should be trying to, or the attributes that we should try to aspire to, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. And also, he described in a hadith, in the same hadith, al-muwatta'una aknafan, those people that are humble. What is that character? That character is to be humble. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was so humble. When people used to come from a foreigner or somebody from outside used to come to the majlis, the sitting of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with the sahaba, they could not tell even he was the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, where he is in amongst the majlis. Subhanallah. People, and he want the position for people to stand up for them. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam didn't want this. You don't need to stand up for me. He was so humble, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We have to aspire to being humble, And here when he says "Una aknafan," it's like when you're to bring your head down, and this is what we understand from it. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, "Wa'ibadur Rahman, Ibadur Rahman, the servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, alladhina yamshuna 'ala al-ardi hawnan, who goes in this earth, walks freely in the earth, hawnan, with humbleness. Wa idha khatabahumul jahiluna qalu salama." And if an ignorant person spoke to them, they said salam. They're humble. So this is number four, my dear brothers and sisters. And number five is Allah loves those with good akhlaq. Allah loves those with good akhlaq. In another hadith, إِنَّ اللَّهَ كَرِيمٌ يُحِبُّ الْكَرَمُ وَيُحِبُّ مَعَالِيَ الْأَخْلَاقِ. And He loves those with excellent character. Allah loves generosity. Allah loves is generous. And He loves generosity. And He loves those with excellent character. Allah loves those people with excellent character. And He doesn't like لا يبغض الفاحش البذيء. In another hadith, those people are vulgar, those people are rude and sarcastic, people who have kibr and pride. Allah does not like those people. This is in the hadith. If we think we are good Muslims, are we improving our character? Are we developing ourselves? Are we thinking of and looking at the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, how he was such a great man, uswatun hasana, the greatest example sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So it reminds us that if we want Allah to love us, then we improve our character, my dear brothers and sisters. And also, even in Yawm al-Qiyamah, we want the mizan and the scales to be strong and heavy, right? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam again mentioned in a hadith an Abi Darda an Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam qal ma min shay'in athqalu fil mizan min husni khuluqi. There is nothing in the scales of a person's scale more heavier than good character, good akhlaq, good manners, my dear brothers and sisters. And obviously, after la ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah, then we need, and our actions, we need those akhlaq. We need to have that means to make that right side heavy, my dear brothers and sisters. And Abi Hurairah radiallahu anhu said that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was asked that who are those people the most that enter Jannah? And أَكْثَرِ مَا يُدْخِلُ النَّاسَ الْجَنَّةِ فَقَالَ. And he said, who are those people that are so many, yani their attribute, they have this attribute and they're entering Jannah, so many of them. تقوى الله وحسن الخلق. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is that person who has taqwa Allah, fear of Allah, and good character. You have to have these two both, my dear brothers and sisters. And those that enter the nar are those that enter because of their mouth or their private parts, meaning the sins they do with their mouth and their private parts. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us the opportunity to learn more about developing our character, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. And finally, my dear brothers and sisters, just some piece of advice, that we remember that how can we apply it today? We have to remember that the easiest way and the most a person sees you in your daily life is your own family. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was خيركم, he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the best of you, خيركم, خيركم لأهلي. The best of you are those who are the best towards whom? Your family. وَأَنَا خَيْرُكُمْ لِأَهْلِي. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is saying, and I am the best of you towards my family, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And in another riwayah, لِنِسَائِهِمْ. and to their wives. We have to be good to our family first. No point in coming to the masjid or going around speaking to others for 5 minutes, 2 minutes, 10 minutes, few hours at work. We are one way, and when we go home, we are another way. We nasal Allah al-afi, we ask Allah for protection, and we try to improve ourselves bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. And Ibn al-Mubarak said about husn al-khuluq, about your good manners, what are those things? How can we achieve it? He said, bastul wajh, to smile. Whenever you see someone, smile. Don't be grumpy. Be smile. And وَبَذْلُ الْمَعْرُوفِ, do as much good as you can. Whenever you do good, do it to the best that you can. وَكَفُّ الْأَذَى, and to avoid harming others. Avoid harming others. And we need to remember, my dear brothers and sisters, that there are three categories that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made for us of husn al-khuluq. The first is our duty and husn al-khuluq to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We must be humble, we must be obedient, we must worship, we must love, we must praise. These are essential akhlaq. This is part of our ubudiyyah, worship to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the second one is to others, humans, humanity. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, even when a janazah came past, a Jewish janazah, he got up and he showed respect to this person. They were like, what are you doing? The sahaba. But Imam al-Nawawi commented on this and he said, this is the ukhuwah of humanity, to show the brotherhood of humanity. And finally, to ourselves, we must have husn al-khuluq, that we should take care of our body and our health. And famous hadith of Salman al-Farisi, that he would do so much ibadah, so much that he would be not do what he was supposed to do in his daily chores or being good to his wife, meaning intimacy and so on. Then Rasulullah said, verily, indeed, your wife has a right over you, your guest has a right over you, and your body has a right over you. Finally, my dear brothers and sisters, let's target to learn about the Prophet's life and seerah. And let's make dua as he did. Rasulullah made dua to improve himself. And this is Rasulullah. Who are we? We need it more. We need to make dua. And you are the ambassadors, remember, for Islam. In the West, we're living here. Every single one of you, your character, your akhlaq, this is key, this is important, my dear brothers and sisters. And two things, some people are very extreme in the fact that they do so much good deeds, and the hadith I mentioned before is innal muflis, that person who is bankrupt is that person who does so many good deeds. He prays and he does good deeds, but then he demolishes it, removes it by saying, slandering somebody, by causing harm to someone. And all of those good deeds are taken from him. And in Yawm al-Qiyamah, maybe that so many, if he's harmed somebody, that good deed was of his has been taken, and then he's thrown into the hellfire. Nas'alullah al-afiyah. Then there's another group of people who say, no, Islam is just akhlaq. La, you have to do good deeds. You have to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, insha'Allahu ta'ala. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين من كل ذنب فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله الطيبين الطاهرين وعلى أصحابه أجمعين والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، أيها المؤمنون، إن حسن الخلق من أعظم ما ينفع المؤمن يوم القيامة ويثقل موازين حسناته. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم: ما من شيء أثقل في ميزان المؤمن يوم القيامة من حسن من خلق حسن. فعلى المسلم أن يقتدي برسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم، حيث كان يتمثل الأخلاق القرآن وآدابه في معاملته مع جميع الناس، حتى قالت عنه السيدة عائشة رضي الله عنها: كان خلقه القرآن. عباد الله، إن الله أمركم بأمر بدأ فيه بنفسه وثنى فيه بملائكته، فقال تعالى: إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي، يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. وقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم: من صلى عليه صلاة صلى الله عليه بها عشرا. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. وارض اللهم عن الخلفاء الراشدين أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي وعن سائر الصحابة الأكرمين وعن التابعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. اللهم زيننا بمكارم الأخلاق، اللهم زيننا بمكارم الأخلاق، اللهم زيننا بمكارم الأخلاق، وارزقنا الإنابة إليك والرجاء لك والثقة بك والتوكل عليك والعمل الصالح والدعاء المستجاب. اللهم إنا نسألك بموجبات رحمتك وعزائم مغفرتك والغنيمة من كل بر والسلامة من كل إثم، اللهم إنا نسألك الفوز بالجنة والنجاة من النار. اللهم لا تدع لنا ذنبا إلا غفرت، ولا هما إلا فرجت، ولا دينا إلا قضيته وعفيته، يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين، اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين، اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين، وأذل الشرك والمشركين. اللهم ارفع عن المسلمين البلاء، اللهم ارفع عن المسلمين البلاء يا أرحم الراحمين، اللهم ارفع عنهم الكرب يا رب العالمين. اللهم ارفع عن المسلمين الكرب والشدائد والكربات. اللهم ارفع عن المسلمين في الشام ما نزل بهم يا رب العالمين. اللهم ارفع، اللهم ارفع عن المسلمين في الشام ما نزل بهم من الكرب والشدائد والعظائم يا رب العالمين. اللهم واجعل الدائرة على من ظلمهم يا رب العالمين. اللهم يا ذا الجلال والإكرام كن بالمسلمين رؤوفا رحيما، اللهم أحسن عاقبتهم، اللهم أطعم جائعهم، اللهم واكسي عاريهم يا رب العالمين، إنك على كل شيء قدير. اللهم واشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين يا أكرم الأكرمين. اللهم اشرح صدورنا ويسر أمورنا. اللهم إنا نسألك الجنة، اللهم إنا نسألك الجنة وما قرب إليها من قول وعمل، ونعوذ بك من النار وما قرب إليها من قول وعمل. عباد الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. وأوفوا بعهد الله إذا عاهدتم ولا تنقضوا الأيمان بعد توكيدها وقد جعلتم الله عليكم كفيلا، إن الله يعلم ما تفعلون. اذكروا الله العظيم يذكركم وادعوه على نعمه يزدكم، ولذكر الله تعالى أكبر، والله يعلم ما تصنعون. قوموا للصلاة فإن الصلاة تنهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر.